All right, we're going to talk about using your front sight in a confrontation. A lot of schools teach that you need to focus on your front sight, and this is really based upon unrealistic perceptions of how fights actually take place. All right, now in training, okay, when you're learning how to shoot, you have three focal points. You have rear sight, front sight, and target. Now instructors tell you to focus on your front sight because it's the middle object. Okay, so your eye can only focus on one thing at a time. Now there's nothing wrong with this teaching when it comes to basic marksmanship. All right, everybody needs to understand basic marksmanship. However, in a confrontation, you will not focus on your front sight, okay, just out of nature. Although your trainer drills it into you, you need to worry about what's going on here. Okay, so first of all, if I'm this close, all right, I should not be looking at my front sight. If I'm looking at my front sight, then I'm probably having my arms extended outward, and it's not a realistic training method or a realistic application of using a handgun, because if at this distance, they can reach out and grab my gun, they can cut my arms, shoot my hands, etc. Okay, so anytime you're in close and the gun is out, that's not good. That's not realistic and practical. Understand that. Okay, now if I focus on my front sight and not the threat, then I can force myself into tunnel vision, okay, because then I may lose focus of what he's actually doing, what his hand's doing, etc. Okay, so it's very important that you understand that in a life or death situation, you probably aren't going to see your front sight. All right, now if you're, you know, at a distance, you need to take an aim shot, by all means do that, okay, but when we're in this close, you're not going to see your front sights, because more than likely, you should be in some kind of retention format, all right, where you're indexing your finger and you're doing point shooting, or in my case, I actually have a laser grip on mine, a Crimson Trace laser grip, and I know exactly where that dot's going to be, so I'm not going to see my front sight anyway. Okay, so just understand that realistically, you aren't going to see your front sights. I don't care what somebody tells you. If you're focusing on your front sight, then you're probably going to die, because you have your gun extended outward and the gun can be taken away from you and you can be getting stabbed, etc. Okay, now I'm not saying you are going to die. I said you're probably going to die, because this isn't a realistic teaching. Okay, bringing your front sight up. First of all, it takes me longer to get the gun up. I should be shooting right out of the holster. Okay, I'm not going to see my front sight. Right, we teach a variety of shooting methods in our advanced pistol fighting class, which is now called integrated concealed carry. And the whole weekend, you never see your front sight, or you never see your sights, period. Okay, so understand that. I understand the teaching behind it, because they are trying to get students to focus on where their shots are being placed, but that's why I have a laser grip, because I won't be able to see my front sight or my sights at all in a confrontation. So again, it's a good reason to have a laser grip on your gun, and if not, then you're gonna have to index shoot with your fingers in index and bring the gun up and start shooting. All right, but this business of sticking your gun out, seeing your front sight's not gonna happen. Even if I bring my gun up and I stick it out towards the threat, I'm not going to be looking at my sights, but you probably shouldn't be doing that either. All right, so just remember that your gun is not your salvation, regardless of what anybody says. The likelihood of you taking someone immediately out of the fight is slim to none. All right, understand that. If you don't believe that, then maybe you need to watch our videos on caliber and shot placement. They're two separate videos, actually three, because shot placement is two segments, but you need to understand that your gun is not your salvation. Okay, if you take the time to look at your front sights and see them at 10 feet on end, then you're probably going to get seriously injured or killed. As always, train hard, train often, and most of all, train realistically.